Well, happy Thursday, everyone. It's going to be a kind of a cooler day out there today. That cold front that came through yesterday definitely dropping our temperatures to 50s for daytime highs. You might see a few spotty showers this morning, but for most of us, it will be cloudy before we see a clearing heading into later today. Rainfall will return tomorrow night. We're talking after 8, 9 o'clock before we begin to see some of that widespread rain. It will become very heavy. We're looking at thunderstorms early Saturday morning and then cold and blustery for the rest of Saturday. Let's take a look at these winds. These will not be sustained winds, but these will be wind gusts. You can see by mid-morning Saturday, we've got wind gusts in the 50s in the mountains, near 40 across the upstate. And even though by the afternoon we're looking at sunny skies, by Saturday afternoon, we're still going to keep those pretty blustery winds around. So just know Saturday is going to be a cold, blustery day after starting off on a wet note. Outside right now, live Super Doppler 4HD radar, we've got a lot of clouds. We're still unsettled, so a couple isolated showers will make a comeback as we go into mid-morning and early afternoon. Still, most of us stay dry. We'll clear out nicely heading into later this afternoon. And tomorrow, we will kick off the final weekend of winter, and it's going to be a pretty nice day. But heading into tomorrow night, here comes that widespread rain later in the evening. Most of the heaviest rainfall in those isolated thunderstorms will come through Saturday morning when many of us are sleeping, 2, 3, 4 a.m. Of course, meteorologist Sydney Sullivan will be on the air Saturday morning, kind of tracking this in and out of here. It's going to finish a snowfall for the mountains, especially in higher elevations. That colder air is funneling in, and boy, again, it is going to be very cold on Saturday. How much rain will fall overnight Friday into Saturday? Well, look at that. It's going to be a lot of rain in a short amount of time. Many of us will end up with about another inch or so in terms of how much snow will fall. I think the GFS has a better grasp of it. I think half an inch will be on the higher end, unless if you were in really high elevations above 3,500 feet. Temperature wise, we're in the low 50s today. We'll bump up to low 60s tomorrow. A few early morning thunderstorms Saturday morning, but by Saturday afternoon, we are clear and dry. And Sunday morning, everyone awakens to freezing temperatures. And that, of course, is the day where we also spring forward, lose an hour of sleep, gain an hour of daylight.